Sharks caught on drumlines will no longer be killed, but tagged and released, following a significant court win by environmentalists. While the ruling is limited to the Great Barrier Reef for now, experts want the decision expanded, but some are concerned it could lead to an increase in attacks.
It's a risk, always in the back of your mind when you step into the ocean.
Some reports of a shark attack in the Whitsundays.
For decades, the go-to response in Queensland has been to drop drumlines, then shoot and kill the apex predator, but not anymore.
Overwhelming and incontrovertible evidence that killing sharks does not decrease the risk of shark bite.
The court ruling means sharks will now have to be released, not put down, unless they're unlikely to survive. The ruling applies only to the Great Barrier Reef for now.
As I said, if the decision's based on animal welfare and the ethics that surround that, there's no reason it shouldn't extend to the whole Queensland coast.
Since 1962, 19 different species have been culled under a shark control program, including great whites, bull and tiger sharks. The new ruling will see those three species tagged and released, and smart drum lines installed, which automatically alert authorities when sharks are caught so they can be released within 24 hours.
Between the years of 2001 and 2016, there was over 2,400 tiger sharks killed. Now, that's just one species. Since the 60s, it would have been in the tens of thousands.
This decision will see shark populations gradually increase again, with tagged bull sharks known to travel from as far as the Great Barrier Reef, even Vanuatu, all the way down to the Brisbane River and the Gold Coast. Politicians claim it will lead to an increase in shark attacks.
The ban will. So I can guarantee any new moves will be to the benefit of the sharks.
We need to ensure that we're putting people before sharks.
The government agrees, announcing it plans to appeal.
We will always put human life first. The community expectations are that their beaches are kept as safe as possible.
Shannon Marshall-McCormack, Nine News.